Klasse 10 und ich natürlich auch, wir begrüßen euch zu einer Theateraufführung. Das heißt Aufführung, weil es jetzt ja, das erste Mal ist, dass wir dieses Theaterstück auch Zuschauern vorführen. Ihr seid jetzt die ersten Zuschauer, die sich das Theaterstück Forbidden Love anschauen dürfen. Wie der Name schon sagt, findet das Ganze jetzt auf Englisch statt. Wir müssen also sehr gut zuhören. Ihr wollt ja sicherlich alles verstehen. Ich glaube, eine ganze Reihe von euch spricht schon sehr gut Englisch und wird dem Ganzen dann auch sehr gut folgen können. Für alle anderen, ihr versucht, so viel wie möglich zu verstehen und habt bitte ganz viel Spaß bei dieser Theateraufführung. Klasse 10 hat in ca. 3 Wochen, 2,5 bis 3 Wochen, dieses Theaterstück selber geschrieben, auf Englisch, auswendig gelernt. Denn so ein Theaterstück muss man ja auswendig lernen. Man muss ja wissen, was man sprechen soll in den verschiedenen Szenen. Klasse 10 hat auch die Dekoration hier selber erstellt und sich auch selber eingekleidet, also Gedanken darüber gemacht, welche Bekleidung zu diesem Theaterstück passt. Das Ganze ist also schon ein Stück Arbeit gewesen, das auf den Weg gebracht wurde und jetzt fertiggestellt wurde. Und bevor Klasse 10, also diese Schule nun verlässt für immer, nochmal praktisch an euch ein Abschiedsgeschenk, dieses Theaterstück, dieses selbst erstellte Theaterstück. Viel Spaß.
Let us take you back to a time in history where tradition and power were dominant. Neighbors made into enemies, lands conquered and stripped of their independence. The only way to ensure any possibility of peace was matrimony.
Mother, our scouts have informed us about the rich grounds of the Indian Empire.
Very good. I shall think of a plan to conquer what was meant to be ours.
Good idea.
That your entire kingdom rests on something vital for our further development. Now, of course, this is your land, but you know it is of British grounds.
Yes, the gods are ready to drop it here. But I also said, I cannot allow this robbery. So as you will be up as my people as I can use.
Why do you talk in such a manner to me? I'm your superior.
Yes, we are aware of this. Our people come first. Surely you as a queen should understand that.
All right. Let's take a step back and rethink all of this. I mean, we should come to a conclusion where all our people can profit from it.
What do you propose?
Marriage. I mean, your daughter is now of marriage age, and I offered a union with my eldest son, Edward. What do you say?
How would our people profit from that?
With our nations united, you profit directly from the British economy. And through that, our nations can be connected.
Yes. We accept this term.
But only your word as a queen.
Okay, you have my word as a queen.
Let the party rock!
Oh, my favorite song! Maharaji!
I thought you wouldn't come. I'm so happy to have you here.
No, my love, of course I would come to see you.
So what about my dear brother, Edward?
What's with him?
Will you still marry him?
I don't have a choice. My parents are forcing me to marry him. I want you to be by my side for the rest of my life.
I will always love you, and if needed, I will fight for you. You are the reason for my entire existence.
I don't know what I should do. I don't want you to get hurt either. Can you talk to your brother and convince him not to marry me? What will happen if your family knows about our relationship?
I think everything will just get more complicated. As long as no one knows about this, we can meet up and spend time together. We must be careful.
Oh, well, I love you so much. I hope everything will be better with time.
Don't miss me, my love. I will always be by your side.
Both Priyanka and William have a splendid time together just before they leave. As Priyanka returns to her chamber, Prince William stays a while and tries to think of a possible peaceful solution. The next evening.
Why in such a hurry, brother? Come drink with me.
Sorry, I have things to do.
What could be possibly so important this time of the night?
It's a project. I have to go.
What is he up to? I have never seen him like this.
Prince Edward I saw the sight of his brother and his bride in this courtyard and felt his heart break. He fell to his knees and cried. He brought himself up to He returned to the castle to bring his news to his mother.
My heart has been broken by the cell I just saw. My dreams have been smashed. I feel empty. I don't have reason to live anymore. My very own brother has betrayed me, has taken my bride, the love of my life, my everything. I am going to kill him!
What bad times have come over us? What an outrage! This horror has made my two sons hate each other. These Indian bastards will pay for their act and feel my wrath. Come. William, how could you dishonor me this way?
Yes, how could you? Does that mean anything to you, brotherhood?
Edward, enough.
What's going on? What are you talking about?
We know that you've been fooling around with a woman that was meant to be your your brother's wife.
But I love her.
This does not interest me. Come on, we talk to the Maharaj. Where's your husband? We need to talk to him.
Maharaji! Maharaji, we love Maharaji.
Your daughter has broken the terms of our agreement.
Maharaji!
As we're compensating for this act, you shall give us the material for our note under no
cost. Maharaji!
What are you talking about?
Your brother's been unfaithful with Logan. He's been fooling around with her, and he was meant to be Edward's bride.
How dare you accuse my daughter of such a thing?
Shared between her and the English prince was never forgotten. Death takes many years, but love is everlasting.